conversation sure. on. So give the Ethereum pitch. I'm curious overall, what made you click on it?
Do you care about security? Yes. Okay. Where have all of the hacks in cryptocurrencies come from? Bitcoin has been hacked twice. Oh, but how? The inflation bugs. Some guy minted 6 billion extra Bitcoin in 2010. Oops. Bug. Oops. They had to roll back the chain and fix it. The same shit happened again, except this time the guy that found it, instead of just using it and becoming infinitely wealthy, what a nice guy, he disclosed it to the developers and then they fixed it. Originally, they lied about it. Originally, they said it was just a denial of service attack. But actually, it was a denial of service attack with a mint as many free Bitcoin as you want. Who knew? Well, they knew, and they told you, you know, afterwards. So Bitcoin's had two inflation bugs. Monero's had an inflation bug. Bitcoin's had an inflation bug. Ravencoin's had an inflation bug. XLM's had an inflation bug. These things happen all the time. Why? Because when you want to make the code better, oops, you accidentally fuck something up that affects consensus. And then people can mint free coins. Hex doesn't have this problem because the code is locked. Ethereum also doesn't have this problem. It's never happened to Ethereum. And Ethereum has a bug bounty program. So you can get paid to find bugs in Ethereum. Can you get paid to find bugs in Bitcoin? No, just by stealing the money. So wouldn't it be smart for Bitcoin to have a bug bounty program? Yes. Wouldn't it be smart for Bitcoin to try and introduce modularity to its software to isolate the wallet consensus from the network? Yeah, it would be great. Then they could be more like Hex and more like the Hex Ethereum combo, but they're not doing that. Instead, the developers of Bitcoin are going off and making their own side projects. So when you see Adam back tweeting, what's he tweeting about? Liquid. Does Liquid have anything to do with Bitcoin? No. It's its own fucking software code base run by its own set of developers that takes away Bitcoin's actual use case, which is settlement. Don't settle on Bitcoin, settle on our side chain, right? So, and then they have cloud mining play too. And who's left Blockstream? Peter Woolley left Blockstream, went to Chaincode Labs. Some other badass dude just left Blockstream and went somewhere else. And everyone's been calling out Blockstream forever and just no one listens, right? Samson Mao sells toxic maximalist hats while investing in ERC-20 tokens and being paid in ERC-20 tokens with a toxic maximalist hat on for sale. What? Are you kidding me? What is this bullshit, right? Be honest, tell the truth, I do it. It's okay. You can tell the truth about shit, right? So Ethereum versus Bitcoin. Ethereum's never had an inflation bug. It does higher transactions per second. It has scalability now. You can do 2,000 TPS with on-chain security guarantees through any layer 2 roll-up that you want. You can use Matter Labs Optimistic. You can use ZK Sync's zero-knowledge roll-ups. You can use, OMG's Plasma shit. There's all these things that work now, that scale now. So Ethereum has never had an inflation bug, can't roll back the chain. That's their major problem way back when. It was smaller, so you could roll the chain back. If they could roll back the chain back, they would do it now for Gavin Wood, who wrote Solidity and who wrote most of the Ethereum code. He's got $150 million locked up because he had a multi-sig failure that he wrote. And if anyone in the world was going to get bailed out, he is the most inside human being possible in the world. If anyone could get bailed out, they would bail him out. They're not bailing him out. So it's $150 million proof. It's probably more now because the price has gone up.
That they're not going to be going through a chain.
They're not rolling back. So we've got proof that they're not rolling back. We've got scaling now. We've got bounty programs. We've got more decentralized mining. If you want to mine Ethereum, you can do it with your video card. If you want to mine Bitcoin, fuck yourself. You can't. You need to go get $1,000 and send it to some world weird country you don't live in and hope they send you the mining machine on time and hasn't been tested too long and milked for its profitability. And then you finally get it, and then you can contribute to the Bitcoin network. Bitcoin has 42% of all of its economic energy and 2,000 addresses, centralized as fuck. Something like 60 or 70% of the mining is in China. Could you think of a more censorship-friendly country than China that would be more likely to cause network problems, since they're like the grand champion, global grand champion of filtering internet. The Great Firewall of China filtered more internet than anything else ever in history. So that is the absolute not place where you want your hash power, right? So what does Ethereum have? Ethereum has already got tested a proof of work change if the miners get shitty. Miners get too shitty, we're changing to proof of work. Fuck you guys. And they've already put forks in the code where the community said, all right, miners are gonna get paid less. And then they just pay the miners less and the miners take it. Awesome. That's a better setup. That's a better ecosystem. So you're getting higher throughput with less pollution, with a more decentralized mining ecosystem, with more backup plans that are already tested to take over if the miners get shitty, with scaling already done, with bug bounties already done, and more developers and working on smarter stuff. All the ZK rollup guys, all the scaling guys are all working in Ethereum ecosystem. I mean, some of them are doing, they're like other like Ethereum killer plays or
one
whatever.
Thing I wanted to ask you about, Richard, sorry on that pitch. Okay. I think you gave a pretty good pitch overall on it and even tackled on a few things. Yeah, sorry. Okay, so one thing I wanted to ask you here in this case, and actually maybe you can build on this in the sense of scalability, is I remember a while back, you know, you were pretty like, especially back in the day when you were really big on Bitcoin, big on proof of work.
Yeah.
Obviously with the 2.0, I'm in the boat that it's going to take a long time to get there.
Sure.
Everyone I've talked to, yeah. So basically, I'm just curious, do you think in this case, like going to proof of stake is a better step for Ethereum in this case, or do you just think
it depends.
Maybe? Yeah.
I think it will, like... I think it'll be very late because all software is very late and it always has been and always will be. Mm. So I think it'll be very late. I do think we already have proof that federated models with reduced security, reduced censorship resistance, but higher throughput are totally functional. For instance, EOS. EOS is just, you know, 21 guys deciding whether they want to let you keep your money or not. And that's it. And usually they do. And so, look, that system hasn't failed yet. We have other proof of stake and distributed proof of stake systems that have not been hacked, which just show that this particular vector of attack, it's not a thing. And by the way, proof of work, it's actually just proof of stake in electric bills and hardware bills.
Yeah.
So it's just an alternate proof of stake. The difference is that you don't have like the nothing at stake attack where you say all chains are valid, but really... only one of them was, but since you said yes to everything, you got paid anyway. Like, so there's, but you cure that through slashing, which is people put up a security bond, and if they catch you saying shit that ain't right, they prove it, then they take your money. So,
exactly.
So it's like, there's also problems with the economics. So Hex solved staking. They're still trying to figure staking out from an incentive perspective. So they're trying to decide how much you should get paid, right? And there's risk. If you have any type of hardware downtime, you're losing money. If you have a cosmic ray do a bit shift on your CPU, you're losing money. Like, and if you see the test nets, people have lost money on the test nets and they just end up getting fucked. So if you want to, Vitalik has a video called So You Want to Be a Casper Validator, and it explains all the ways, and it's really actually hard and it's a job. So the difference, like staking Hex, you just lock it and then you don't have to do anything. But staking ETH, you have to run a server farm and keep the uptime and hope that nothing goes wrong or you will lose money. And running, keeping computers up, it's a full-time job. It's not easy at all. And because people hand that work off to other people and introduce a centralization. So it's like, I don't care if it works or not. Like, I'm happy with the way Ethereum works now. Yes, we have these spikes for fees, but those spikes for fees cause more buy pressure and cause the price to go up. So when did Bitcoin make all-time highs? When fees were at all-time highs. And when did Ethereum make all-time highs? When fees were at all-time highs. So all-time high fees is the price you pay for a bull run. So for me, it's like an okay trade. If we can get USDT onto more L2 stuff, because it's not decentralized anyway, they print by accident a billion and then take it back away. They've done that. They're like, oops, we printed an extra billion. Our bad. We'll just delete this. That's how secure that system is. And so, since it's fake secure anyway, you can put that on L2, no problem, and then that would take away about 25% of the transactions off of Ethereum, like this. And those transactions don't actually add value to the Ethereum network because they used to run an Omni, and Omni only did $200 a day volume, didn't do shit for the Omni price, so they ain't doing shit for the Ethereum price. So I would love to see the Tether transactions offloaded onto an L2, and then that would leave more space for everybody else that really needs the decentralization. And then if we could get Uniswap, which I think is like 60% of all of the gas usage now, Uniswap V2, if we could get that onto an L2 of some sort, then that would help.
It's literally going to be.